All right. Campaigners are everywhere, Chairman. Just going outside our village, I've already experienced them. But the COMELEC has limited personnel. How do we manage to double down on possible vote buying incidents?
Well, of course, we are relying on our people, on our the electorate to report to the commission election the any attempt or any incidents of vote buying. Again, I can promise you, this is my commitment. We will act on your complaints, on your reports, even if the report or complaints are not under oath. We will immediately act, and we will direct our personnel in the field to immediately investigate. This happened already in the last 2 days when the arrests were made in Navotas for purposes of vote buying to be committed on behalf of candidates in Malabon. And so this is a lesson or two on the part of those who are trying or will attempt to commit vote buying in the last 2 days before.
Physical evidence physical evidence can show vote buying is happening. But what about on e-wallets?
Well, on the part of e-wallets as well as the other forms of modern way of vote buying, we were able to prevent that with all due respect and with all modesty, simply because the Banco Central ng Pilipinas, including the Anti-Money Laundering Council and the platforms such as Paymaya and GCash, were actually helping. In fact, the Banco Central had instructed these entities to report anomalous transactions, even transactions in volume, meaning we do not care about the amount being deposited or being passed through to these platforms, but what we are concerned of are deposits in volumes, such as, for example, a person depositing to 200 individuals worth 500 pesos or 1,000, we will immediately presume that person as engaged in vote buying.
All right. Let's go now to what's happening in ABRA, Chairman. They reported more than 200 candidates having withdrawn from the elections. Any concerning reason for this?
284 the last count, Ma'am Rica, but there's nothing to fear and there's no nothing to be concerned of, simply because when we investigated together with the PNP and the AFP and our local COMELEC, the reason for the withdrawals was actually not because of fear or threat, but because there were elderly people in the locality trying to talk to relatives who are candidates to just withdraw in favor of another candidate in order to ensure the peace in the and among the families. And so some of these candidates were withdrawing because of that, not because of threat or any other reason.
That's some good news. But I believe that, I don't know if I've already asked you this before, Chairman, but are there also reasons that prove the presence of political dynasties in provinces? You don't go up against your cousin or your brother or your father for the moment. What do we make of this?
Yes, Ma'am Rica, of course, the reason why it's always heated, the barangay and SK elections, because public officials, especially elective local officials, are interfering in the affairs of the campaign, in the affairs of the candidates, and again, this is a warning to all of them, even if we are not able to charge them because we do not have jurisdiction for those who are not running, but take note that there are other cases such as the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act, as well as the Ethical Standard for Government Officials and Employees. Yesterday, Secretary Abalos promised that they will go after those who may not be candidates, but elective local officials who are interfering in the election for the BSKE. We have to leave untouched the BSKE, and that's the reason why there are irregularities and there are incidents, election-related incidents at that, being committed in the last few days.
There are groups of teachers requesting for safety, and Senator Wingat Chalean of the Basic Education Committee in the Senate is also requesting for the safety of poll workers. Does COMELEC have any agreement with state forces to possibly provide escort, especially on areas of concern?
Yes, Ma'am Rica, even including our MOA with the DILG, our MOA with the PNP and the Armed Force of the Philippines. Again, we will give the utmost protection and security to our teachers. They are the modern heroes. We cannot conduct the election without our beloved teachers. We are going to utilize almost 700,000 teachers, Ma'am Rica, nationwide. And of course, our priority will always be their safety as well as the safety of COMELEC personnel in the field.
Even before the last week has been going on, you mentioned earlier, Chairman, that COMELEC is very much ready for the BSKE election. So any other last-minute issues that you're concerned of?
course, the last 2 days will be very, very crucial, especially on the issue of vote buying. We will be carefully watching every move of these candidates. Again, we respectfully request our voters, our people, to please report to COMELEC any of this irregularity. We are going to investigate. We are going to disqualify these candidates. We have proven that in the last few days. We disqualified candidates, and we even suspended the proclamation of winning candidates who have pending disqualification cases in the commission election. So therefore, kindly please report to us and cooperate with us, and we will prove to them that because of our unity, all of these irregularities will definitely not happen.
It's going to be a hectic weekend for you, Chairman. Safe journeys to Abra later on. Thank you very much for your time, Chairman, and you have a good afternoon ahead of you.
Thank you very much, Mamrica. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you. We are joined by COMELEC Chairman George Garcia.